My name is Moshawa, and in this video, I'll show you how to configure PC-lint Plus to support the IAR embedded compilers. PC-lint Plus can be configured to support any C or C++ compiler. This is accomplished by creating compiler configuration that informs PC-lint Plus of important compiler characteristics, including where to find the system headers, the size of fundamental types, and so on. Generating a compiler configuration is the first step in utilizing PC-lint Plus. So let's get started. First, we will locate where the PCLP config utility is located. So for me, that is under the PCLP directory config, and that's where the utility is located. Keep in mind that if you still need to download PC-lint Plus, there's a video that we have down in the description. You can follow the first 2 minutes of that video to get started, and then you can come back and we'll be able to set up the compiler configuration. Running the PCLP config utility successfully depends on three steps. The first is installing Python. There's plenty of tutorials out there to cover that topic, but we will also leave a link down in the description. Two is installing the modules regex and pyaml. So let's get started on that. There are two ways to opening up a shell. One of them is typing in cmd into the path and hitting enter. Another way to do this is to also open up a shell window by right-clicking and open in terminal. And here we will type in the command pip install regex. And the second command we'll type in is pip install pyaml. And now that these modules are downloaded successfully, we can point out the third step, which is to make sure that pclpconfig.py and compilers.yaml are in the same directory. PCLPconfig is a command line utility, so we will invoke it from a shell. All information provided to PCLPconfig is done via shell arguments. Here's a preview of the command that we're going to be constructing. The minus minus compiler argument specifies the compiler family. We can obtain that information by using the minus minus list option when invoking the utility. So for example, we'll type in the command python pclp underscore config dot py with the minus minus list option. And if we scroll up, we can see the IAR compilers. So here we can see the IAR ARM, which is the one that I'm going to be configuring today. All the IAR compilers follow a similar process for creating compiler configurations. Just make sure that you select the correct compiler family. In my case, it's the IAR minus ARM. So we'll type in IAR minus ARM. The minus minus compiler bin argument specifies the path where the compiler executable is located. To find the location of your compiler, we would open up the IAR embedded workbench. We'll click on the help menu, about, and then product info. We will select the compiler that we're working with. So in my case, that will be the ARM compiler, and we'll click on details. This will take a few seconds. Once the page is loaded, we're able to scroll down and find the C/C++ compiler and copy the path. So that's where that is. Control C, press OK, and we'll add it to the compiler bin argument. Compiler configurations generated by PCLP config consist of two files, a .lnt file, which contains relevant PC-lint Plus options, and an accompanying .h file that is automatically included at the start of every module. That header file contains predefined macro definitions and compiler intrinsic function prototypes. The minus minus config output lint file and the minus minus config output header file specify the names of the files to be generated. So in this case, we'll name them co-iararm.lnt and co-iararm.h. The minus minus compiler options argument specifies a list of any compiler specific commands for your project. For example, if you're compiling with C++ instead, you can use the minus minus C++ option. But in this case, I'm not going to be adding any compiler options, but I just wanted to mention that to you. The minus minus generate compiler config specifies the type of configuration that PCLP config should create. Before running the command, it seems like that the compiler bin is missing quotes because the path does have spaces. Once the adjustment is made, all we would have to do is make sure that the arguments are separated by spaces instead of new lines, like so. And now we're able to copy the command and run it in the shell window. The lack of output is actually correct, and this is what's expected. And if we open up where the configuration utility is located, we'll be able to see that the .lnt and .h files were created successfully. From here, you can open up the header file, for example, with a text editor that you prefer. And from here, we'll be able to see if the header file was generated correctly. So we can see that all the macro definitions are included in this. So this is what a successful configuration should look like. We can do the same thing for the LNT file and opening it up with an editor of your choosing. And from here, we'll see all the relevant options included and the important ones being the include directories that are noted correctly. And now all you have to do is make sure that you call the configuration file when you're running PC-lint Plus before any source files, PCLP64, and then the configuration name, along with the test.c, which is the module, for example. I hope you have found this video to be helpful. If you want to go further and integrate PC-lint Plus to your IAR Embedded Workbench IDE, you can follow the video that we have linked down in the description. If you are running into any issues or have any video topic suggestions, feel free to reach out to us on support@pclintplus.com. Have a good one.